Got power, Captain. Thank you. Thank you. Toyota, check your purse, check your pockets, check something, see if you have.
followed by the graduates, enter the auditorium and remain standing for O Canada.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Evans, and thank you for your 10 minutes of home.
Welcome everyone to Bansby, the Better Bansby Second Day School commencement of 2018. Bronco for life.
And I am Julie Montes, a French immersion science teacher here at Banting. Both of us are honored to be your MCs for this evening's ceremony. We sincerely hope you all enjoyed yourselves this evening. This is, above all, a celebration of the achievements of our young Banting grade 12 students. A few points of business before we begin. Firstly, we encourage family and friends to anticipate when their favorite student will be called so that they can come up to the front of the stage and take a couple of quick photos. This is a bit of a spoiler alert, but we will be proceeding in alphabetical order. Today also marks the final day of Ramadan, the Muslim holy month, most commonly known for prolonged periods of fasting. Students and families who are celebrating, please feel free to eat and drink as needed.
We invite students to pause briefly at the front of the stage to ensure that their family and friends get the perfect picture. So family and friends, please make sure your phones and cameras are charged and the flash is ready to go. In addition, we kindly ask that all families please remain in the auditorium until the end of the ceremony in order to celebrate the accomplishments of all our students. And lastly, in keeping with the spirit of tonight's occasion, we encourage everyone to put their phones on silent and or vibrate so that we can all focus on all the graduates. Thank you.
So now I'd like to call on Banting's principal, Joan Cooper, for a few opening remarks.
Wow, I'm not sure we've ever seen this auditorium this full. Welcome, everybody. Staff, honored guests, family, friends, welcome to this evening, a celebration for the 2018 class. Before I address this year's grads, I would like to acknowledge all the adults, the parents, the grandparents, the aunts, uncles, anybody that has helped support these students along the way. This is a journey that you have taken with them. Thank you to all of the staff that have supported our students along the way. Thank you for those early morning music practices. I'm an early person, but all of the music folks are always here before me. The evening games, the late night, last minute assignments, you too have every reason to celebrate tonight. Grads, as you sit here tonight, I hope you can reflect upon your last 4 or 5 years here at Banting. I hope that you have memories starting right from grade 8 and your first experience at Banting and Wildcard. Remember the hypnotist, the magician, that late night, and how hard that gym or cafeteria floor really is. Your experience continues into grade 9 in your first field riot and our famous mud bath. You can't talk about Banting without remembering the other sleepovers, DARE and Relay for Life. A couple of things about Banting: we like to sleep, eat, and buy swag. Each of you can share your success in music, athletic endeavors, and academic achievements, or your support in leadership of a number of charity events. I hope you will remember today and say with great pride that that was a great day in high school for happy times. We have been proud to have been part of your life's journeys. In thinking about what the future may bring, I urge you to celebrate your successes, your achievements, and the people that have meant the most to you. It doesn't matter what you choose to do in the future. It doesn't matter whether you're a teacher, great career though, a doctor, mechanic, or a gardener, as long as you remember that every type of work has its own dignity. With regards to the future, dream big. Dream helps you do great things, and to make the impossible possible, to set the direction of your lives and to make change for the better. To dream big puts spark and energy into each day. In closing, I want to reference Dr. Seuss' light-hearted children's story, Oh, the Places You Go. The story is a meaningful message about the importance of seizing new opportunities, keeping an open mind, and trying new things. I've learned that life is certainly one huge adventure, jam-packed with unexpected twists and turns. The excitement, the adventure, and craziness of those experiences, however, make life special and create long-lasting memories. Enjoy your adventure and the places you will go. Congratulations to the class of 2008.
Some students
Are we ready? That one person is. Our first graduate of the evening is Michaela Devine, who is planning on studying social science at Russia.
Congratulations.
kinesiology at Western University next year. She has also received a scholarship. Congrats. Our next graduate is Salman Ahmed, who is planning on studying engineering at Western next year. Congratulations.
Our next graduate is Katie
Alcama, who is planning on studying recreation and leisure at Fanshawe College. Congratulations. Congratulations to Nadia Ayaz, who is planning on studying communication studies at York University. Congratulations. Congratulations to Zahal Azizi, who is planning on studying pre-health and sciences at Fanshawe College. Our next graduate is Brooke Burry, who is planning on
Our next grad is Kayla Byers, who is planning on studying environmental science at the University of Waterloo. Our next graduate is Aloysius Capulon, who is planning on studying civil engineering at Fanshawe College. Congratulations. Our next graduate is Liam Carr, and he is planning on studying French to become a teacher. Congratulations, Liam. Our next graduate is David Carver, who is planning to work for Southwest Pet Center and expanding his hours. Congratulations, David. She will be receiving the French Delft B2 certificate, and I would also like to invite Wayne McGregor and John Morris to present her with the Royal Canadian Legion Art Purchase Award. Kayla was selected for her beautiful artwork that will be displayed at the Royal Canadian Legion Byron location. The art will return to Banting to be displayed as a part of our permanent collection. Congratulations, Kayla.
And the entrance scholarship as well.
studying architecture at Carleton University. Claire will be receiving their French Del B2 certificate this evening, and I would like to invite John Barwell to present the Edge Imaging Award as well. Claire has been part of the athletics throughout her time at Banting on the volleyball and soccer team. She has been on Multicultural Committee, the Poet Society, and Environmental Club. She has volunteered at the London Public Library through high school. Claire also excels in academics. Congratulations, Claire.
And Sheraton.
go.
Culinary at Fanshawe after taking a year off. So now I'm finding yourself. I did.
studying food and nutritional sciences at Brush University. She also received an entrance scholarship, and Jenna will also be receiving the French Del B2 certificate. Congratulations. Cecil Haythorn-Thwaite is planning on studying Arts Foundations at Field Art. I would like to invite Julie Montez to present the Peggy Sadler Social Justice and Equity Award. Cecil has been an integral member of the Advancing GSA. Cecil is always willing to listen and help others. It is Cecil's big heart and passion for including everyone that makes them an inspiring leader. Congratulations, Cecil. Jeremy Height is planning on taking a year off to work before he attends Bible College. Congratulations, Jeremy.
science and thought and civilizations at King's University. And Jillian has always received an Emmett Scholarship. Congratulations, Jillian. Abby Jenkins is planning on studying concurrent BEd, ECE, BA Psychology at University of Windsor. And also, she will be receiving the Eleanor Catherine Wallace Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations, Abby. George Duclos is planning on studying engineering at Windsor. Congratulations. studying medical sciences at Western.
Thank you.
Tonight we are giving over $7,000 worth of scholarships and awards out, so that's who deserves a round of applause. Thank you. He's into the real estate business, so he's going to buy and rent houses in the Toronto area. Congratulations. Next up, we have Derek Liku, who is planning on studying economics at King's University College. Congratulations.
She is a mentor to other students on student council and has worked tirelessly to organize activities
Center with the Banting Alumni Leadership Award. Jessica is a key leader at Banting. She has given countless hours on student council, this year as president, and has years of helping with Wildcard, DARE, Grade 8 Day, Parents Night, and on Social Justice Committee. Banting has always been able to count on Jessica as an outstanding leader. Congratulations.
Congratulations to Paula Perez, who is planning on studying
planning on studying chemistry at Ryerson University, but first is going to return to Banting. Congratulations.
Engineering Physics at Carleton University. Jenna will be receiving the French Delft B1 certificate, and I would like
Allie is someone that is always positive and dances her way into the hearts of the She truly embodies the spirit of the Bronco. Congratulations, Allie. Community of London Race Unity Award.
Ishan Siddiqui is planning on studying engineering at Western University.
Science at University.
language, running camps, serving dinners for people in need, and volunteering in many capacities. Mind Health with Wild Card and taken part in the Relay for Life, Social Justice, Bronco Buddies. Maya is very passionate about helping others and giving back. Thank you for all you do, Maya.
immersion at the University of Ottawa, and she has received an entrance scholarship as well as the Del B2 certificate. Congratulations. Emma Ward is planning to return to Banting this fall.
Me, but I don't know if Banting can really handle that.
Mason. Also, I just want to point out Meg and Gleb and all of their hard work giving out the diplomas and the awards to our
individual who was selected by the graduating class of 2018 to represent them in giving a valedictorian speech. This individual is not only close to my heart, but is close to the heart of Banting. She represents the school as a whole with her intelligence, positivity, creativity, leadership, and ginormous heart. I now present to you your 2018 valedictorian, Jess Nixon.
The amount of fire drills that we've had every semester.
The amount of times we've listened to our favorite song as we drive away in the car, and the amount of times that we've realized that we have to come back to school the next day. It's the amount of times that we've shoved our way to a mountain of grade 9 that come in every year just as lost as we were. The amount of times we've had to fight our way through the walls of grade 10 that seem to be around every corner, blocking every hallway as we try to make it from first to second. We can measure our time here in the amount of times we've fallen up the stairs, dropped our books, been late to class, taken 15 minutes to go to the washroom. The amount of times we've gotten lost every year. The amount of times that we haven't had time for our homework, but we have had time to binge watch entire Netflix series in one weekend. From our first day of school to our first class, our first high school summer to our first exams, from our first dance to our first steps into the school, all the way until our last, we have fought, overcome, and become entirely new people. We've experienced the highs, lows, and the mediocre in-betweens of life, and we leave here with the opportunity to take with us the lessons that we learned without the baggage that they might carry. The word release is defined as freeing from confinement, obligation, pain, emotional strain. It's liberation from anything that holds you back. When we leave here, we can release ourselves from the bad things that were a necessary part of our experience and rather take with us the good things that happened here. When we look back, we'll remember the smiles. We'll remember the surprise B+ you got on the essay that you wrote the night before, because let's face it, we wrote all our essays the night before. We'll take with us the peers that turned into acquaintances, the acquaintances that turned into friends, and the friends that turned into family. We'll take it with us the sense of camaraderie and belonging that we developed here. We'll remember the best parts of our high school experience because they were the most important parts of our high school experience. We will bring us with us the things that happened here, the things that will bring tears to our eyes in the years and decades to come, not because we're stressed out of our minds, freaking out, or just sad. They'll bring tears to our eyes because we'll be happy that they happened. Our time here will pass in the blink of an eye, leaving us filled with memories and emotions that we will not soon forget. We will leave here, walk out those doors, live our lives, and we will take Banting with us every step of the way. Thank you.
Again, we are so proud of you.